Brother, thank you for coming and putting on a very fine degree work this evening. There are refreshments in the dining room, and I look forward to talking to each and every one of you over a cup of coffee.
Wow. That was a unique experience, wasn't it? You know, you're probably like me. There are a number of reasons that I decided to become a Master Mason. But I think the thing that I like most is knowing that wherever I go, there's always a group of guys out there willing to count me as brother. I could tell you stories about how the Masons have helped me already, but I wanted to share some information with you, so suffice it to say that the Masons are there to help their brothers in times of trouble. And what I wanted to talk to you about was the fraternity within the fraternity. Scottish Rite Masons, for example, are brethren who have decided to pursue more knowledge while at the same time strengthening their bonds as brothers. Scottish Rite Masonry was originally formed in France and then came to the United States in 1801. Now, the Northern Masonic jurisdiction, of which we're a part, was then established in 1813. The Scottish Rite is composed of the 4th through the 32nd degrees, and once you join, you become a 32nd degree Mason. You may have heard about the 33rd degree. Well, the 33rd degree is an honorary degree to which one can't make application. As a matter of fact, a 32nd degree Mason must be nominated to receive this distinctive and honorable recognition. The exciting thing about becoming a Scottish Rite Mason is the extensive personal growth that can come from experiencing the degrees. As a matter of fact, the Scottish Rite is often called the intellectual branch of Freemasonry. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. Here I am, I've spent all this time going through 3 degrees, and now you're talking to me about 29 more? Well, yes, but there's quite a difference between the Scottish Rite and your Blue Lodge degrees. The Scottish Rite degrees are presented in what's called an allegorical or a theatrical format, and as such, there's absolutely no memorization required on the part of the candidate. Now, the meetings or reunions may happen up to 4 times a year, but you only have to attend 1 to become a Scottish Rite Mason. Over time, as you attend more meetings, you should eventually see all 29 degrees. You can attend reunions in any valley within a recognized Supreme Council. Now that you've heard about the ritual aspects of Scottish Rite, let me tell you a little bit about the day-to-day life of a Scottish Rite Mason. Last weekend, for example, my family and I went to a Rite Life event. There were games for the kids, plenty of food, and at the end of the event, there were fireworks. As always, my family had a great time. You know, we attend as many of these events as possible because we find that we're growing closer as a family as a result of our association with the Scottish Rite and other Scottish Rite families. My wife is helping out with the Children's Learning Center fundraising walk, so she's going down to the Masonic Center tomorrow for a committee meeting. As for me, well, I like helping out with the stage work during the degrees, and I'm sure I'll be helping out with the Children's Learning Center fundraising walk as well. You see, the Children's Learning Center is one of Scottish Rite's 4 charities. The Learning Center provides free tutoring for children to help them overcome dyslexia. Our other charities include the National Heritage Museum, which my family and I plan to visit when we're on vacation this summer. Additionally, every single year, the Abbott Scholarship Program provides over 400 scholarships for deserving students. And finally, we also help fund research to find a cure for schizophrenia. Now, all these charities are supported by Scottish Rite Masons. Now, if someone were to ask me why I think they should consider becoming a Scottish Rite Mason, I'd say there are a couple of reasons. First of all, there's that indissoluble chain of sincere affection, which definitely becomes strengthened through Scottish Rite Masonry. Additionally, there's a certain comfort in knowing that your family is always associating with like-minded families whom you can trust. Obviously, there are a number of reasons why I think you should become a Scottish Rite Mason. Here's some of your other brother's reasons.
I've belonged to other organizations, Kiwanis, Legion, so forth, Elks, but this organization is probably the most bonding. It's one where you meet people that have good character and good reputation. They're respected in their community, and I enjoy being with people like that.
I truly enjoy participating in the 1-day reunions or the 2-day reunions. It is so much fun to be with different men from all backgrounds and all experiences, and you're there for one common bond and one common goal is to, you know, show the degrees in the best way possible. It's a great experience. I remember
obviously the Blue Lodge is where it all starts and is a very important part of it, but the friends that I've made in each of the Masonic bodies just have enriched my life.
Our Tyler Muggsy McCammon was on the stage crew and a real influence in a lot of us members of Rubicon Lodge to join the Scottish Rite. The 33rds that were in Rubicon Lodge always participated, and if all these guys were involved in it, it must have been a good thing, and it is.
And there's a lot of camaraderie, which I really enjoy with the Scottish Rite.
I joined the Scottish Rite for a lot of reasons, and the reasons that I joined are not necessarily the same now that makes me want to keep coming back. The allegories that are taught throughout the Scottish Rite teach valuable lessons in life that are applied in your daily activities, not only with families, but friends, and in the working environment. The important part about the Scottish Rite with the family is the picnic in the summer, the events that they have. My children are able to meet other Scottish Rite Masons children, and they have built this little networking of being able to talk to other Masons kids, and they email each other, they IM each other, and they get the strong bonding between them. And it's based upon the brotherhood and fraternity that we belong to that is now leaching out into the children, and I think it's a very important part of their life. And they also read my bulletins and tell me when the events are happening and remind me that they want to go.
It's a character-building organization through its many activities and community services.
Fraternal involvement with everyone there, you know, the more you're seen there, the more people get to know you, the more you're recognized, more people know your name, and it's a lot of fun because you go somewhere where you really feel like family and where you really feel valued.
And certainly just to grow in Masonry. You're with some of the finest people you're ever going to meet in your community. And if you hunger and thirst for knowledge that you can gain from it, and if you're interested in participating and sharing and passing that on to someone else, that is a great way to
and
do it.
Since then, I've enjoyed various activities that Scottish Rite provided, not only at the main branch, but my county association, and in my chapter also has activities for us to belong to.
You keep learning from the experience and growing. And that's what it's really all about.
And it was a natural thing after I became a Blue Lodge Mason to join the Scottish Rite.
Thanks for helping me close up the lodge room. I've really enjoyed talking to you, although I guess I've done most of the talking. Here's a packet of information for you to take home and review. Inside, you'll find some more information about what's happening in the local Scottish Rite Valley, as well as some names, email addresses, and phone numbers of brethren who'll be more than happy to sit down and talk with you and your family about the Scottish Rite. Congratulations again, and welcome to the world's oldest, largest, and greatest fraternity. We better join the guys and see if they saved us any refreshments.